Welcome back to Fuzz and Linux Journal. Michael here. Ubuntu is pretty much the most popular Linux distribution for the Linux desktop. Especially since 2006, Ubuntu has been able to take the desktop by storm. A distro that was user-friendly and easy to install. Launched by a solvent millionaire, Ubuntu was the undisputed industry leader for a relatively long time. But why is it like that? What makes Ubuntu so exciting and popular? What is the dark side at Canonical behind the Ubuntu success story? A story about questionable decisions. Ubuntu developers changed relationships with the open source community and the role of Ubuntu today. That's what it is about now. Ubuntu releases a new version every 6 months. Every fourth version of this gets 5 years of long-term support, short called LTS. The intermediate versions, are also called interim versions, only receive maintenance for 9 months. Ubuntu itself recommends the LTS versions to all users with important systems, mission-critical systems. That means the system should simply run. The interim version are for technically minded users who could live with a small error. To be fair, it must be mentioned at this point that errors in the interim versions are quite rare. But if you get involved, you have to upgrade the system every 6 to 9 months. So, if you like fewer changes to your system, you should use the LTS version, because there are only bug fixes and security updates for 5 till 10 years. Ubuntu is considered as a user-friendly Linux distribution, so Ubuntu was recommended for newcomers. Ubuntu further simplified the installation process from its early days and has retained this advantage to this day. Installation with the installer is easy and quick to do. Ubuntu not only ships open source software, but also proprietary software and drivers to improve the user experience directly. This is also noticeable for newcomers if everything runs immediately after installation. From time to time, Ubuntu automatically delivers backported newer kernels for the LTS versions via the hardware enablement stack. As a result, users regularly get a fresh kernel and new drivers without having much to do. Although Ubuntu ships with the GNOME desktop, unlike many other distributions, Ubuntu has its own design team. This team created a Yarrow theme and performed a very good job. It's a very good appearance that offers a high recognition value, and at the same time, it looks flat and modern. Most Linux distributions maintain a good relationship with the community. But the company Canonical, which is behind Ubuntu, develops Ubuntu according to its own ideas, which sometimes goes beyond the heads of the voluntary developers. In fact, decisions are made and implemented no matter how the community thinks about them. Canonical implements what they want in Ubuntu. That started a few years ago with the Unity desktop. In addition, there were questionable decisions with search results via the dash search in Ubuntu Unity. Here, search results were forwarded to Amazon. With the display server Mir, Ubuntu also started a questionable venture on its own commission. The projects just mentioned were abandoned by Canonical. I don't want to judge here whether they were good or whether it wasn't better to give them up. I mentioned this in documentation, however. The latest highlight or lowlight, depends how you want to see it, is the Snap container format, whose back-end server infrastructure is not open source and therefore completely under the control of Canonical. This may not be uncommon on other platforms that a manufacturer has a complete control over the app store. With most Linux distributions, however, software deployment is not implemented via a closed software app store. So with Ubuntu, this is different, and for many adherents of the open source software philosophy, this is a thorn in the side. While there are also Ubuntu users for whom the source of the app is not so important. Ubuntu has always been based on Debian. Thus, Ubuntu also uses the Debian package format for a long time. In the meantime, Ubuntu has switched to swapping the packages. Some applications no longer come as traditional Debian package, but as Snap container. Renowned examples for this are the Chromium browser and the Firefox browser on Ubuntu. These are always delivered as a snap package. Ubuntu, as well as the Chromium and Mozilla developers, hereby argue that this will speed up the deployment of the packages and makes it simplified and accelerated. After all, only one package needs to be built and deployed for all current supported Ubuntu versions instead of creating and distributing a separate package for each version. For example, Ubuntu 80.04, 20.04, 22.04, and so on. It should also be mentioned that not all packages are maintained in the Ubuntu LTS versions, because Ubuntu and Canonical only provide the security updates for the packages from the main and restricted package source. With Ubuntu Pro, this changes now. However, many popular desktop applications come from the other two repositories, namely Universe and Multiverse. So it could happen that you use software on the Ubuntu desktop that has known security gaps and would therefore actually be questionable. This topic is not new and has been known in the Ubuntu universe for some time. Like I said, with Ubuntu Pro, they now react on this and do not stick longer on this paradigm. Many years ago, I used Ubuntu myself for roughly 2 or 3 years full-time, but I didn't stay with Ubuntu permanently for various reasons. Nonetheless, I've used Ubuntu in various ways over the years. So it should be clear that I don't consider Ubuntu to be a bad system. But on the contrary, I feel that Ubuntu's contribution to the Linux universe as a whole system is often misunderstood. There was so much great upstream stuff that came out of Ubuntu. Linux Mint or PopOS are just two of many very awesome examples. But the decisions of Canonical and the result path for Ubuntu are not uncritically uglied by me. So I am not an Ubuntu fanboy. Still, Ubuntu is a good Linux distribution for all casual users because it's easy to use, offers good hardware support, and looks fresh and modern with the Yarrow theme. Aspects like Snap or the collection of diagnostic and telemetry data must not be hidden. So if you don't like them, you better stay away from Ubuntu. But now I'm of the opinion that the Interims version are maybe for some users the better choice. You have to do the system upgrades every 6 to 9 months, but in return you get much newer software, a newer Linux kernel, and as a result, fresh drivers. Yes, I know the non-LTS versions might contain bugs, but I would counter that by not making the jump to the next Interims version directly after the release. Instead, I would wait for 1 or 2 or 3 months at a time. By then, all the bugs will have been fixed. So, what would my Ubuntu system look like? Well, as I said in the beginning, there are advantages of the Ubuntu LTS versions as well as the disadvantages of this edition, and the same goes for the Interims version. Personally, I have no problems with Ubuntu or Canonical's decision as long as you can easily reverse the impact of the decisions, if necessary. So with little effort, I can delete Snap from my Ubuntu system and install Flatpak instead if I want. I would then have a cleaned up Ubuntu system that would have a fairly up-to-date software stack. But now I can already hear some of you saying that you would have to put in a lot of effort and that you could use instead a different Linux distribution. What can I say? Yes and no. It depends on how sympathetic you are to Ubuntu. In theory, the effort is a bit more at the beginning, but if you purge Snap and turn off the collection of diagnostic data, there's nothing to do anymore. With Ubuntu, you let yourself be involved in the decisions to a certain extent by Canonical, but that's not as bad as some pretend. I personally use two Linux distros on two different computers. One distro is actually Ubuntu 22.04 LTS. Everything has to be running on this machine whenever I need it. The other machine is running PopOS. Since I get newer components such as the Linux kernel, but also many software packages are provided in a native Debian package format by System76 for PopOS. Sometimes I do not need to install a Flatpak package. And yes, with PopOS you don't have to first remove Snap and install Flatpak because Flatpak is standard there. But I like both distros. So I use both distros exactly where I see the greatest strength of each distro in respect to my workflow. I correlate at this point that Ubuntu is quite important as a platform and thus serves as the basis for many great Linux distributions. The actual Ubuntu desktop distro has improved again with 22.04 and thus moved forward again in my favor. you can see that the Ubuntu design team is doing a very good job, and that proves that Canonical shows that the focus is again on the Ubuntu desktop. Now before I go, I would like to thank you for the kind attention. By the way, you're welcome to leave your opinion in the comments. If you liked that video, please feel free to subscribe to my channel. You can also show by the thumb up how you like it. That gives me corresponding information and helps the video. So, stay healthy, take good care of yourself, and then hopefully see you at the next video. Bye bye, peace.